Welcome back, and let's go ahead and take one last look at our local satellite and radar. That cold front that is going to be dropping our temperatures is already situated over the area. Now, we're not going to feel its effects until later on this afternoon. We're still going to be able to get our normal daytime heating in, but it's going to be occurring rather quickly and rather early in the day, leading us to see a falling temperature trend as we head in towards these mid-afternoon and late afternoon hours. We're going to hit our high temperature rather early in the day, but we did see a little bit of some moisture moving on through, as well as the extra cloud cover we're dealing with that is unfortunately putting a damper on any of those viewing pleasures for the actual lunar eclipse this morning. Now, as for current temperatures, not much of a change throughout these first few hours this morning. Bloomfield and Lancaster have fallen a degree down to 39. Fairfield still holding on to 34 degrees. Rest of our areas very, very consistent, right about 39 degrees. As for those winds, not much of a change as well. We're still looking at up towards 20 miles an hour as your wind gusts, and we are going to see these getting up towards about 20 to 25 as we head in towards the afternoon hours. So very windy for today, but we're already on a very mild note, and it's only going to keep going up from here. So what can we expect for high temperatures? Well, as for the wind chill values, actually, we are still dealing with Fairfield and Centerville below freezing, 25 and Fairfield 27 for the feel in Centerville. Those high temperatures today, though, check that out. 49 around Kirksville, 51 in Macon. Should be looking more for about 50 degrees at the max. 48 and 47 is a great consensus for high temperatures around our area. A very mild day, well above average for this time of year. But unfortunately, that changes. Take a look at the overnight lows, and then we're going to see not a lot of a change as we head in towards tomorrow. So 29 in Macon, 27 in Kirksville, 20 in Ottumwa. That's the overnight lows. Now, these are the highs. Not much of a change on the map there, is there? 27 for the high in Kirksville, 22 in Albia. We are going to be watching for a falling temperature trend throughout the day on Thursday. By the time you're heading home from work on Thursday, temperatures are going to be down in towards the low 20s and upper teens for us. Taking a look at the future cast, that cold front pulls off towards our southeast. High pressure is going to eventually build in over the course of Thursday into Friday. And then we can start talking about that actual snowfall as this next clipper system starts to pull its way into the area. We're going to see a little bit more development on the backside of it here. While we do see a lot of this is showing to and starting to develop off towards the east, we are expecting this to continue its extension to the west, bringing with it snow to our area as we head in towards those afternoon hours of Saturday into Sunday. How much are we going to be expecting? Well, earlier models were showing much more development out towards Fairfield, pushing it upwards of an inch to 1.2 inches. But overall, we are expecting most of our areas to be very similar to where Fairfield's at right now, up towards half of an inch across southeast Iowa, less than half of an inch across northeast Missouri. As for your extended forecast, a chilly start to the work week is expected. Now stick with us. Fred is up next with sports.